Today is the annual second collection for Catholic Charities. It is the only second collection taken up during this summer. So the ushers will be going around a second time with the baskets for that purpose. Thank you.
Good morning. Good morning. And welcome to St. Edward for our celebration of the 11th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Before we begin, we ask that you please silence your cell phones. Thank you. Our presider this morning is Father Rick. Please join us in singing our gathering song, number 542. Sing to the Mountains, number 542. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we gather this beautiful Sunday morning on this day when our nation pauses to celebrate our Father's living and remember our Father's deceased. So as we gather this morning as one family in faith, We take a moment to pause and reflect on those times that we've sinned so that we might prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and your blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that following in your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches, tear off a tender root, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs, and all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name, Most High, to proclaim your kindness at dawn and sing your faithfulness throughout the night. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. The just one shall flourish like the palm tree, like a cedar of Lebanon shall he grow. They that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. They shall bear fruit even in old age, vigorous and sturdy shall they be, declaring how just is the Lord, my rock, in whom there is no wrong. Lord, it is good to give thanks to
you. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wheels the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed that, when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. The kingdom of God, Jesus speaks to and about in our gospel reading this morning, and he did that fairly frequently throughout the gospels, the three synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and also, of course, the gospel of John. The kingdom of God was a focal point of Jesus' earthly ministry. In his coming, in the word of God taking flesh, becoming incarnate, becoming one like us, in all things but sin, the kingdom of God was present in him. And he came to plant that seed among fallen humanity. What had existed at the beginning of creation, we all know the creation story of Genesis, the beginning of Genesis. What had existed at the beginning of creation before sin entered into the picture and perfect communion with God was lost could begin to be recovered with Jesus' coming and the coming of the kingdom with him. In today's gospel, Jesus describes how that kingdom would grow from something the size of almost invisible, a tiny mustard seed, to something so much larger. And his point was this, that from almost nothing, from something barely noticeable, with God's help, something wonderful could bloom and flourish. From little could come much. So a question for us this morning as we reflect on this parable is, how does the kingdom that Jesus came and planted among us, how does that kingdom grow and flourish? Now we know, we absolutely know that it's clear that God does not do it all on his own. God obviously could do it all for us, but he doesn't. He doesn't do it all on his own. Now, obviously, the ushering in of the kingdom was all God, because it was through the life and death and resurrection of Jesus, again, that seed was planted among us and in us. But God wants our participation in the growing and building up of that kingdom. Jesus didn't just come and it was all accomplished and then send the Holy Spirit and it was all accomplished. God desires our participation. And it's by desiring our participation, when we really think about it, that God shows us how much he respects us and loves us and wants us to be channels of his grace to others and doers of his will. And it's not just through the things that we are rich in or that we are immensely blessed in that God wants us to build up the kingdom. God also wants us to use the things that we have little of, or perhaps the things we might consider that we lack in some way. Because God will take those little things and transform them into things of great size that can and will, if we allow it, to make a real difference in the lives of others. And so the other question we have to ask ourselves this morning is this. What do we, each one of us, what do we have little of? Or to put it another way, what could we all certainly use more of within us to really help build up the kingdom? I've got just a handful of examples. I'm sure you can come up with others. What about compassion? Well, we all pretty much feel like we're compassionate, but are we compassionate enough? Are we compassionate as God calls us to be compassionate? How does God call us to be compassionate? God wants compassion to grow in us until we see everyone else's struggles and suffering and hardships and sorrows as our struggles and sufferings and our hardships and our sorrows. What about generosity? Well, we're all generous. We all give to the poor. We all help support the church and other worthy institutions, other worthy causes. But God wants us to grow in generosity until blessing others with good things becomes second nature to us. And it's not something we need to ponder or reflect or think about before we do it. It's just second nature. What about forgiveness? Well, we all forgive, I think, most of the time. God wants that to grow in us until first we more thoroughly understand our own need for forgiveness and then thereby extend that gift to each person who has wronged us or wronged another in some way. What about kindness? Well, we're all kind, right? Well, God wants that to grow in us also until whatever possible, we could call it mean-spiritedness or wrong attitude or bad intention within us, so that those things dissolve away, leaving only in us patience and understanding and love. And of course, the list could go on, but we get the point. We get the point. So my brothers and sisters, my parish family, the kingdom of God on earth is present. It absolutely is present. But it's not always visible. It's begun. Again, it began with Jesus' coming. But it's still growing. And it needs to grow until it becomes that large plant, that large bush, that tree of every good thing. One that will bring peace and joy, respite, shelter and safety to all those who choose to dwell within its branches. But the degree to which all that happens and the speed at which it happens, the clarity with which is brought, which it is brought into focus, that's mostly on us. That's our part. God gets it going. God helps keep it going with the power and the action and the direction and guidance of the Holy Spirit. But God wants us to do, if we want to put it this way, and it doesn't mean to dishonor it in any way, God wants us to do the grunt work, the work on the ground. And that's just the way God wants it. Do we want the same? Do we want the same? Or do we want God to just take up what needs to be done and get it done? Do we want to help grow the kingdom, or we want to leave it to God? I think we know the answer. So let's not ignore our part in it. Who knows what we might become in the process? The greater disciples, the greater saints that God wants us to be. And who knows especially what the world might become? The seeds are there, and God's help is always there. So let's grow ourselves, and let's grow the kingdom, so that we can become more than we could ever expect, and that so we could build up the kingdom of God in our midst, growing it to be so large. Think about it this way. Once we go out, as Deacon Bob always talks about, once we hit the doors and go back out into the world, growing that kingdom to be so large that all might see it, that all might notice it, in part in and through us, and see all of its goodness and beauty, and therefore desire a place of their own within it. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. Our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church.
I confess
one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Striving to build up that kingdom of heaven, that kingdom of God that our Lord came to inaugurate, we offer our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father, that our church and all who minister within it may continue to bring the good news of salvation through Jesus Christ to all peoples. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That forgiveness, tolerance, and reconciliation may be offered by the world's leaders to each other, fostering peace and harmony throughout the peoples of the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may each take our own gifts and return them to the Lord through our stewardship of time, talent, treasure, and prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the great bounty of our country be used to ensure that no one suffers from hunger or want. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of our fathers who we honor this day, living and deceased, may find favor with God as they watch over us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may find peace with Christ, and may their prayers bring us assistance as we journey to the kingdom of God in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those enrolled in our Father's Day memorial, whom we remember in a special way at this liturgy, let us pray to the Lord. Good and gracious God and Father, hear the prayers we humbly offer you this day and answer them according to your will. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join us in singing our preparation song, number 345, Seed Scattered and Sown, number 345.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament. Grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. The fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. For as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased her throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Thank you. behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us in singing our communion song, number 397, This Alone, number 397.
This alone I seek to dwell.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. And our vocation prayer. God, our Father, you made each of us to use our gifts in the body of Christ. We ask that you inspire young people whom you call to priesthood and consecrated life to courageously follow your will. Send workers into your great harvest so that the gospel is preached, the poor are served with love, the suffering are comforted, and your people are strengthened by the sacraments. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You know, in regard to that vocation prayer, I've talked over the last 2 or 3 weeks or so about two young men who were ordained to the priesthood, and then I believe it was 15 or 16 men who were ordained to the diaconate. Two of them are transitional deacons. One of them spent a significant amount of time, number of years, at our parish before his family moved to another part of the diocese, but that was Alex Couris. You may remember his mother, Roseanne, and her involvement with Savior of the World. So continue to keep all these deacons and priests in their new assignments for the summer and for the permanent deacons for however long it may be as they continue to dip their toes into the ordained ministry. Now, on this very special day, if we could please have our fathers stand. If you are a father, a grandfather, a godfather, a foster father, a stepfather, or a father in any way that I may have omitted, please stand. You know, I always say there's nothing else like a mother. Well, there's also nothing else like a father. Our mothers nourish and sustain us. Our fathers lead and guide us in many ways, and even our fathers who have passed continue to lead and guide us as we reflect on their memories of them. So today we pray, God our Father, in your wisdom and love you made all things. Bless these good and holy men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And fathers, happy Father's Day and congratulations. Please remain standing, fathers. I'm assuming for those who rose early to have breakfast, you were served breakfast in bed. Anybody? Or if not, you're being taken out for breakfast or brunch after Mass. Everyone, please let us pray. There you go. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a couple of announcements this morning. The Knights of Columbus will be at the exits, primarily I think the main exit, with those delicious treats called Tootsie Rolls. They're accepting donations, which will help support the Campania Academy and the Gibault House for the less fortunate, and also the Special Olympics. Those are just three of the many, many charities which the Knights support throughout the year. So if you want to grab a Tootsie Roll, and if you're able to make a donation, it would be greatly appreciated. Also, please take home a bulletin. I put a little blurb in the bulletin about the rummage sale. Again, I can't thank everyone who participated in any way enough. It's so much hard work, so many hours. Every year we pull it off, or I should say the volunteers pull it off. In the bulletin it says we raised like 37,900 and something, but we forgot to take the scrap metal over to the junkyard, and that put us a hair over 38,000. So another record, 38,000 for the parish. I'm splitting it about half and half, half to the general fund of the parish to help with operating expenses throughout the year. Half will go into the capital campaign, just kind of building that up because we never know what we're going to encounter as construction and then renovation occur. And if additional costs are incurred, we'll have that money available. If not, it will go back to the parish in some other way. My brothers and sisters, on this Father's Day, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
And our closing song is number 433, Canticle of the Sun, number 433.
Our town.